Let's talk about extrusions for a minute. So these three here are all 4080. They're in the 40 series. They're different though from one another. This is a 4080 that actually has a flat face on one side, so no slots. This is the heavy walled extrusion, the 4080 that we sell with our very super cool tools fence. We sell this in 42 and 48 inch lengths. This is what's called a 4080 light. So this could be a good choice for someone who perhaps had a bad back or didn't want something quite this heavy. It would still work fantastic. And this is a 40 by 100 millimeter. And this one works on RT square. Anything that's 40 millimeters this way or 1.5 inches will work just fine. I just don't use this because it's just too much. It's just too heavy for me to mess with, to take on and off as often as I use it. And this is an SAE model. This is a 1530. So that means it's 1.5 by 3 inches. And this is a pretty popular choice too. I don't think there are as many selections in the 15 series as there are in the 40 series, and that's why we went with this. So, our accessory that we sell, the high auxiliary fence made out of Baltic birch plywood and laminate, will fit on in the slots of any one of these three with no problem at all. And you can just take it on and off in just a matter of 30 seconds with the embedded T-nuts in the track and the countersunk bolts. But let's talk about extrusion straightness now. Well, first off, I want to tell you how I look at the straightness of these extrusions. And I have this Precision 48-inch long Sterrett straight edge. And this is a very expensive Precision straight edge that is guaranteed to 0.2 of an inch per foot accuracy, so that's 0.8 of an inch, less than 0.1 of an inch over 48 inches. But yet this still isn't straight. This is theoretically not straight. The only thing that's absolutely straight on this planet is probably a laser light beam. But it will give you a very good approximation of how close these extrusions are. And so, for example, I have these Mitutoyo made in Japan rulers, about as high a quality a ruler as you can buy. And these are only guaranteed to 1/1000 of an inch per foot. And so they're not even as accurate as this Sterrett. But you can see that they just mate together like there's nothing to it. So I have a feeler gauge out here to kind of show you what I'm, I'll just do a quick demo of testing these guys for straightness. And I don't have the 1/1000 of an inch out because I'm afraid I'll bend it and break it, it's so thin. But I have a 2/2000s, and I have a 0.025, and I have a 3/1000s, 4/1000s, and 5/1000s. So let's just start with this one since this is just where it started here. And so I've got this 2/1000 of an inch, and I'm not able to get this in anywhere really on this at all. So this is actually the extrusion right here that my buddy August Lehman from Chicago sent me that got this whole very super cool tools T-square fence thing started. And you can see that this was a used extrusion that actually had a bunch of holes drilled in it for something else before I turned it into a table saw fence. But here you can see I've got, maybe I've got 2/1000s. Giving me a lot of resistance trying to put it in there. 2/1000s. Nothing there. So these things are very, very straight. Now they're not machined, they're extruded. And what that means is that a billet of aluminum, a big, heavy, solid billet of aluminum is heated up to about 900 degrees and it's pressed through a series of dies under incredible hydraulic pressure. And the dies produce the final shape. So the dies determine what the final shape of the extrusion is going to be. And then after it comes out of the end of the machine, usually about 24 feet long, they grab the long extrusion with very powerful jaws and a tensioning mechanism, and they straighten it and put that final tension into it, which really gives a lot of straightness to these extrusions. but they're not machined, and you know, of course they're not priced like machined items either. So here I'm, you know, I'm looking at this one, and you know, maybe, you know, I thought I saw a little spot right here where I could get the start of 0.002 inch in there. Really not. So these are very, 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 very straight, and very, very straight for woodworking applications. When I first started woodworking, these things were exotic materials. They were not available to people generally, and so I never really dreamed that I could have such an incredibly comprehensive table saw setup made out of these extrusions that I do now. Because the ability to attach jigs, fixtures, hold downs, dust collection systems, stops, it's just really limited only by your imagination of what you can attach to these slots. Bearing guides on the top, they are an incredible resource for the small shop. Okay, well, we've discussed the straightness over the length of these extrusions. Now let's talk about the flatness across the face of the slotted extrusions. As the extrusion manufacturers and engineers have explained it to us, they actually engineer in a slight concave or a slight convex profile across the faces, and that's because they're using these often for connections that are made like this, where they want to have a very slight amount of tension when the fasteners are tightened up. It's not very much. So let's look at these, and let's just, you know, here I've got my feeler gauge out again. And let's start here. This was my original one, and you know, this is a Mitutoyo, Japanese made Mitutoyo combination square. And you can hear that it has just a little bit of rock to it, and I'm 0.002 inch, maybe 0.025, and that's you know, about a fat human hair right there. So that's not very much. And here is that 4080 light, and that is barely can get this 2000 underneath there. So this one is actually concave. This is that 40 by 100, and this one, you can see that it has just a little bit of rock to it across that, and that's 25.0025. So 3000, I can't get it in there. So it's somewhere in between 0.025 and 3000. So not very much at all. Here's this SAE model. And again, you have just a slight variation across the face. And I can get 2000 in there. I can get 0.025 in there, but I can't get 3000 in. And here is the one that's flat across the face, and you know, of course, that's just flat all the way across the face. Let's look at the other side of this one now. It's got 0.002. It really 0.025 concave on this one. These are just properties of the way extrusions with slotted faces are made. Now, this is part of a Festool multifunction jig that I have. That's a very expensive, very high performance jig that does all kinds of things. You may have seen me use it in my videos, and it has the exact same properties. So it has all the slots cut in it, and when you put a ruler across here, this has got concave. It's concave on the inside. That's 0.025. Let's see if 3 will go under. No, 3 won't go. Yeah, 3 will go under here. But it's just the way these extrusions are made and how they're manufactured and engineered. But now they are everywhere. You can get them on Craigslist. You can get them on eBay. 8020, the largest manufacturer, they have an Amazon store and an eBay store. they're just so readily available. It's just nuts.